With very little time to prep this, and out of the blue as Microsoft does, we have a second wave of Gamecasts coming to the remainder of the month of February. It's my birthday this month, and I was hoping for something to blow me away on this list, but I'm still chugging through Cyber Shadow. I'm actually on the very last boss as I record this, and Medium, which I think I still have probably like about another hour left in that game. So with a couple days this month, I plan on finishing those. But if you're new here and you're enjoying the content, make sure to hit that subscribe, like, and comment down below. Now on with the video. First off is Code Vein, best put as anime meets Dark Souls. I played this game originally when it was released in May 2019 from Bandai Namco. The combat is what you would expect from a Dark Souls type game. I love the art style and some of the mechanics. It's also friendly to new players of the genre by the ability to play with an ally or a co-op to help navigate you the pain. If you haven't played this game yet and you're into Dark Souls, give this a go. I think you'll enjoy it. Or if you're just an anime weeb and looking for something to kind of get your teeth into. Pillars of an Eternity 2 Deadfire Ultimate Edition. Now that is a long title. It's a new CRPG that is a sequel to Pillars of Eternity 2. However, you don't need to have played PoE2 to enjoy this sequel, as they do a good job of giving recaps and choices to change the beginning scenario. I have never been able to really be enthralled by this genre. I always felt like it was personally too slow and too much reading. But I do love RPGs, and maybe I'll give this a go. It was rated pretty high, receiving an 85 on Metacritic. Full Contact Racing, Epic Crashes, Fight Over the Finish Line. What else would you expect from a rally derby game? I personally haven't played much racing games except Forza in the past couple of years. Personally, I've been kind of waiting for a Need for Speed Underground remake. I absolutely loved that game for the PS2 in the height of the Fast and Furious movies, and it just makes me miss it even more, you know what I mean? Dirt 5, man, two racing games this month seems a bit much, but Dirt 5 was a new release just back when the consoles launched. So seeing a new game already is kind of nice. I probably would play this over Wreckfest. Rally racing is a blast to watch, and the Dirt franchise has been around for some quite time. Being optimized for the Series X running at 4K 120, for those who were lucky enough to get their hands on an X, this is a perfect game to, you know, give your console a little bit of exercise. I think I might play around, play some races on this one. I think it'd be kind of fun. Space Simulation makes me think of the show Expanse. This game has been around since 2014, but after the recent end of Season 5 of The Expanse, this game might just be the perfect continuation for the vibe that I'm feeling. The game continues to have a loyal fan base, and for good reason, open-ended gameplay with hundreds of hours of stuff to do, see, explore. This is a perfect game to get lost into and really experience what we will never will, sadly. Well, we did land the rover on Mars though, right? So we're making some progress. Now that I have a VR headset, everyone in my livestream keeps telling me I really gotta try Superhot. This is the third game in the franchise. It gives more insight, more story, more signature gameplay. Dance around like a ballerina, avoiding hits and masterfully killing your opponents. I might try this one out and see if it's worth getting for the Quest 2. So guys, a little late on the video, but I wasn't expecting a random drop like that. Being my birthday week as I record, I've been pretty busy doing some fishing, hanging out with some friends. If you're looking to play some games with the community, make sure to jump into the Discord and get to know everybody. But until next time guys, I'll see you around and have a good night.